Hello everyone, myself Vinny Teja, lecturer in chemistry, SKR and SKR Government College for Women, Kadpa. My topic for today's presentation is thermodynamic properties. In this presentation, I am going to focus on definition of thermodynamic property and different types of thermodynamic properties. Any characteristics of a system in which its physical properties are described is called a property. Similarly, the characteristics which can be used to describe the condition or state of a system is called thermodynamic property. For example, temperature, pressure, volume, energy, etc. are considered as thermodynamic properties. Thermodynamic properties are measurable quantities. They have definite unique value when the system is in particular state. There are two types of thermodynamic properties. They are intensive properties and extensive properties. Let us see one after the other. Intensive properties that are independent of quantity of matter or amount of the material present in the system. That means property which does not depend on the amount of the substance present in the system are considered as intensive properties. Examples: pressure, viscosity, temperature, melting point, density, boiling point of the system, specific heat, freezing point of the system, surface tension, concentration. These are all the examples of intensive properties. Let us see in detail. For example, a metallic bar with a mass of 30 kilograms is having 500 degrees centigrade of temperature. If we cut this bar into two equal halves, even that means one is having 15 kg of weight, another is also having 15 kg of weight. But even then, its temperature is not at all changed. That means this property is not dependent on the amount of the substance present in the system. Therefore, the property is independent of the weight of the system. Such type of properties are called intensive properties. Let us see another example. Here, water is present in a beaker, 20 liter of water present in a beaker, and in another beaker, 10 liter of water is present. But whatever the amount of water present in a beaker, but their freezing point and boiling point is same for any volume of the water present in the system. That means freezing point will be 0 degree centigrade, boiling point will be 100 degree centigrade for any volume of the water. Another example is color of the substance is also an intensive property. Here I have given a turmeric powder. Suppose if we take 500 grams of turmeric powder, and in another bowl if we take a pinch of turmeric powder, both are having same color. Therefore, color is also an intensive property. Intensive property does not depend upon the amount of substance present in the system. The next thermodynamic property is extensive properties. The properties which are dependent on the quantity of the matter or amount of the substance present in the system are called extensive properties. For example, mass, internal energy, volume, heat capacity, entropy, heat contents, etc. are the examples of extensive properties. Let us see in detail. Here I have given a beaker with 20 liter of water. If we transfer the 20 liter of water into two beakers, 10 liter each, then the volume gets reduced. Therefore, volume is the property which depends upon the amount of the substance. Another example is wooden log. So, consider this as a wooden log which is having 100 kilograms of weight. If we cut this into two equal halves, the mass is reduced to 50 kg each. If we further cut into pieces, so this 50 kilograms is further reduced to 25 kg each. That means mass is a property which depends upon the amount of the substance. So in this presentation, I have explained what is thermodynamic properties. Thermodynamic properties are the characteristics of a system which describes its physical condition. And I have also explained what is intensive property, the property which does not vary with the amount of substance. And the property which varies with the amount of substance is called extensive property. I hope you have understood this presentation. Thank you.